As you go deeper on the reef, it's mysterious. The water gets colder, it gets darker. The creatures that live there are specifically adapted to live at those depths.
They've got pinks and oranges and purples and reds, and it's really remarkable for a place that is somewhat dark to have all these bright and beautiful colors.
The Twilight Zone is deeper than the normal scuba diving depths, between 100 to 500 feet.
For the diving that we do, using traditional scuba or open circuit equipment is inefficient. So we utilize a closed circuit rebreather.
The rebreather is just an amazing tool that really given us a step forward to what kind of species we can research, what kind of depths we can reach, what kind of areas we can explore, and how we can explore it.
It basically lets you recycle the gas that you're breathing over and over again.
We have to do a lot of technical diving training. Otherwise, when bad things happen, and they do happen, if you're not ready, you're not prepared, you're not familiar enough with the equipment, that's when trouble hits.
You drop into the water and you're free falling, and then you arrive at this deep spot. And we all check in with each other and look around and make sure that everybody's okay, and then we get to work.
The time we have at the bottom is directly proportional to how deep we go and how long we want to stay in the water for a total dive. So if you want to do a total dive time of 3 hours, we can't stay in the bottom for more than 10 or 12 minutes.
We basically come up 10 feet and then we wait a period of time, and then we come up another 10 feet and we wait a longer period of time, and that goes on and on and on until we get to the surface.
Our longest stop is frequently over 90 minutes. Sitting there at 20 feet and looking up at the boat, and the boat's like right there, but you can't go to it. Yeah, it can test your patience.